So let me just explain to you why this is called naive Bayes. What we've done is we said there's unknown concepts. These are our target labels. Let's call them label A and label B. And you don't get to see them. They're hidden, as is always the case in supervised learning. And what you get to see instead are things these things do, like words they use. If they use them with exactly the same probability, you could never figure out who it is. But they use them with different probabilities. And they might use one of them, or 100, or 1,000. But every word that you see, like this one over here, gives you evidence as to whether it was person A or person B. And what you do is, you just multiply all the evidences for every word you see. It's a big product. You do this for person A and for person B. And you multiply in the prior. And when this product comes out, it gives you the ratio of whether you believe it's person A or person B. That is called naive Bayes. It lets you identify from a text source whether this label is more likely or this label is more likely. And you can do this with people, with news sources. You can ask the question, was a text written by Shakespeare or by somebody else? It's a very powerful tool that's widely used all across machine learning. And the reason why it's called naive is because it ignores one thing. And you tell me which one it is. All the individual words in a message, the order of the words inside a message, or the length of the message. Which one is being plainly ignored here?